Good morning. Today we are going to discuss about people optimization. In previous lecture, we have seen about the principal sources of optimization, where we studied about how to construct the basic block, how to construct the flow graph. After constructing the flow graph, how to perform the local optimization and the global optimization. Now we will see about people optimization. This people optimization is done only after code generation. A statement by statement code generation strategy often produces the target code that contains the redundant instructions and suboptimal constructs. That is, what is people optimization means? When we are generating the statement by statement target code that has some redundant instructions, we have to eliminate that redundant instructions. This can be done by people optimization. We have to try to improve the performance of the target program by examining the, by identifying the sort sequence of the target instructions. Those sort sequence of target instructions are called peephole. Peephole is a small moving window of the target program. It is not necessarily contiguous. That is, informations in the peephole should not be in the contiguous. Then we can apply the repeated passes to perform the peephole optimization. So here, what is peephole optimization? That is, you are identifying the sorted sequence of the instructions in the target program that should be replaced by the sort sequence of and faster execution of instructions. That is called peephole optimization. Characteristics of peephole optimizations. Here we are having five characteristics: redundant instructions elimination, unreachable code, flow of control optimizations, algebraic simplifications, use of machine idioms. See how to eliminate the redundant instructions. Before that, you should know what is redundant instructions. When a particular instruction appears more than once, that is used twice or thrice, that is called redundant instructions. So we have to eliminate the we have to keep only one instructions. The remaining thing will be eliminated. See here, you can see the example: redundant loads and stores. Here you are having the instruction move r0, a, then move a, r0. The first statement a, the a statement, the content of the register r0 is moved into a. In second one, the same value of a is again moved into the register r0, because here b is an unwanted instruction, because we already have the register value in a. Again, that is, register r0 contains the a value. So no need to again you transfer that a value into register r0. So here b can be eliminated only if that have the no label. Suppose if it have the label, it cannot eliminate this, because if you are having the label 100, move a, r0, before this you are having move r0, a. This is, these two are different instructions. Here you are moving the r0, a. Then you are having the set of loops. Then you are having the control, that is label here. Suppose here B is not labeled, then you can eliminate this, because it has the redundant information instructions. Suppose B is a, B have the label, you cannot eliminate this. Next, we are having the unreachable code. You see the example here: ask define debug 0. If debug, print debugging information. Suppose if debug value is 1, you can print the debugging information. Otherwise, you cannot come out of this loop. See here that this statement, ask define debug 0, if debug, print debugging information, is converted into three other statements. If debug equal to 1, go to L1. In L1, you are printing the debugging information. The remaining statements are go to L2, then control goes to the label L2. here you can have the jumps over jumps. That is, if V but equal to 1, it is true, then go to L1. In this L1, you are printing the information. Instead of that, you can eliminate the L1. Directly, you can write if V but not equal to 1, go to L2. If it is 1, then print the debugging information. See here, here you are having the two labels, L1 and L2. Here you are eliminating the L1 label. Next, suppose here V but equal to 0, not equal to 1 means it goes to L2. If it is 0, it will print debugging, go to L2, will be carried out. That this print debugging information becomes the dead code. You can eliminate that. Next, flow of control optimizations. Here you are eliminating the unnecessary jumps. Here you are having the statement, go to L1. In L1, again go to L2. See, instead of going your insertion to the L1, again you are going to the label L2. So here you are having the unwanted jumps that will be eliminated here. Here you are eliminating the L1. Directly you go to L2. L2, you are having the label L2, go to L2. Here L1 will be eliminated. Next, if A is less than B, go to L1. L1 will go to L2. Here you can eliminate the, no need to go for L1, then L2. Directly you can see the conditions. If A is less than B, then go to L2. L1, suppose if you are having any information in L1, that go to L2. So here L1 will be eliminated. These are all the flow of control optimizations. Next, you are having the algebraic simplification. You already know how to perform the algebraic simplifications. See here, x is equal to x plus 0. Whenever you are adding 0 with any value, you can get the x. Here, when x is multiplied by 1, you can get the x. So, whenever you are performing the optimization process, x equal to x plus 0 and x is equal to x star 1 will be eliminated. Next, you are having the reduction instant. What is reduction instant? You already know. That is, you are replacing the expensive operation by the cheapest operation. Here, x square is an exponential operation. It is an expensive one. So, you are replacing the exponential operation by the multiplication operation. This is for reduction in strength. Next, you are having the use of machine events. That is, machine instructions. Suppose, here you are having the statement I equal to I plus 1. Suppose, if you are generating the 3-header statement, first you are moving the I into the register and add register with 1. Then again you are having the load that results into the I. So you need 3 intermediate statements to implement this I equal to I plus 1. Instead of that, you can have directly I plus plus increment. That is, INC is a machine instruction that is used instead of 3 statements. That is, you can use the effective and the efficient instructions during the optimization of your target code. So here we have seen the peephole optimization. What is peephole optimization? That is, you are identifying the shorter sequence of instructions that is called peephole, that is replaced by shorter and faster sequence of instructions, faster execution time that will produce the faster execution time. That is called peephole optimization. Here, the content of the window, peephole window, is not in contiguous. Next, we are having the different characteristics, that is redundant instruction elimination, unreachable code, flow of control optimization, algebraic simplification, and use of machine events. Thank you. Thank you.